Hi, all. Christmas came and went, marked only by tragedy. Christmas morning, I got off duty and opened all my packages alone. I missed you all so much. I cried myself to sleep. It's ridiculous. I seem to be crying all the time lately. I hate this place. This is now the seventh month of death. Destruction and misery. I'm tired of going to sleep and listening to outgoing and incoming rockets, mortars, artillery. I'm sick of facing every day a new bunch of children ripped to pieces. They're just kids. 18, 19. Their whole lives ahead of them cut off. I'm sick to death of it. I've got to get out of here. Peace. Linda.
Kent State University in Ohio has had campus violence for three nights, causing the National Guard to be called in, and today the guardsmen opened fire on the students, killing four of them, two young men and two young women.
The National Guard was called in over the weekend by Governor James Rhodes. Today, when 1,500 students started an anti-war rally on the commons, the guardsmen surrounded them. Then, when some students started throwing rocks, the guard moved in with tear gas.
Editor. This letter is from the men who daily risk their lives in Vietnam. In regard to the recent killings at Kent State University, we are sorrowful and mourn the dead, but it grieves us no end and shoots pain into our hearts that the, quote, biggest upset is over the kids who got killed at Kent State, unquote. So why don't your hearts cry out and shed a tear for the 40-plus thousand red-blooded Americans and brave, fearless, loyal men who have given their lives? During my past 18 months in hell, I held my friends during their last gasping seconds before they succumbed to death. Do not judge us wrongly. We are not pleading for your praise. All we ask is for our great nation to support us. To help us end the war. Damn it! Save our lives.
Thank you. At Clark Air Force Base in the Philippines, there were no speeches, no bands, no bunting. Homecoming was gentle. The first man off was Captain Jeremiah Denton, a man who'd been in prison so long, his own teenage son had grown up, gone to Vietnam himself, served, and gone home again. And only now was his father coming home after 8 years.
We are honored to have had the opportunity to serve our country under difficult circumstances. We are profoundly grateful to our Commander-in-Chief and to our nation for this day. God bless America.
God bless America.
Dear Bill, I came to this black wall again to see and touch your name, William R. Stocks. And as I do, I wonder if anyone ever stops to realize that next to your name on this black wall is your mother's heart. A heart broken 15 years ago today when you lost your life in Vietnam. And as I look at your name, I think of how many, many times I used to wonder how scared and homesick you must have been in that strange country called Vietnam. And if and how it might have changed you, for you were the most happy-go-lucky kid in the world, hardly ever sad or unhappy. And until the day I die, I will see you as you laughed at me, even when I was very mad at you. And the next thing I knew, we were laughing together. But on this past New Year's Day, I talked by phone to a friend of yours from Michigan who spent your last Christmas and the last 4 months of your life with you. Jim told me how you died, for he was there and saw the helicopter crash. He told me how your jobs were like sitting ducks. They would send you men out to draw the enemy into the open, and then they would send in the big guns and planes to take over. He told me how after a while over there, instead of a yellow streak, the men got a mean streak down their backs. Each day the streak got bigger, and the men became meaner. Everyone but you, Bill. He said how you stayed the same happy-go-lucky guy that you were when you arrived in Vietnam. And he said how you, of all people, should never have been the one to die. How lucky you were to have him for a friend. And how lucky he was to have had you. They tell me the letters I write to you and leave here at this memorial are waking others up to the fact that there is still much pain left from the Vietnam War. But this I know. I would rather to have had you for 21 years and all the pain that goes with losing you than never to have had you at all. Mom,